Welcome back. In the previous class, I have discussed about the balanced Y delta connection. And in today's lecture, I am going to talk about the balanced delta delta connection or balanced delta-delta system, means both source as well as the load are connected in the delta topology. So if you understood the previous two lecture, means Y-Y connection and Y-delta connection, then this particular lecture is obvious extension of the previous lecture. So again, we are going to define the balanced delta-delta system. So basically, balanced delta-delta system is one in which both balanced source and balanced load are delta connected. So that is the definition of the balanced delta delta connection connected system. So now let us come to the topological connection. So here I have source, and here in this side I have load, and here source is also three phase delta connected, and here you can see that load is also three phase delta connected. Now if you see this particular topology, then what one can see here, that VAB is again exactly equal to V capital A capital B. So it means that if I have delta delta connected system, then analysis is not so difficult. And before going to do the analysis, let us see the goal. And again, goal is the same. Our basic goal here, that is to obtain. So let us write the goal. So goal is to obtain the phase and line current. So goal is exactly like the previous class. So now again, same like previous class, first I have to assume the direction of the rotation of the rotor, and after that I am going to talk about the all other thing. So let us talk about the direction of rotation of the rotor. So what I am assuming, I am assuming a positive sequence . So if you assume the positive sequence, the phase voltage for a delta connected source R. I am going to write the mathematical expression that is VAB, that is if RMS value is VP, then I can assume, since I am assuming the positive sequence, so I can assume that voltage is from this kind of sequence. So whenever something is in positive sequence, you can assume like this. And since this is balanced source, so basically angle is 120 degree apart, but magnitude remains the same. Due to that reason, I am able to write this kind of mathematical expression by assuming positive sequence. Physically, rotor is rotating counterclockwise with respect to the stator. And I have already told you that here line voltages are the same as the phase voltages we have observed here. So there is no difference between line voltage and the phase voltage. So here the line voltages are the same as the phase voltages. And in this particular connection, since we are talking about delta-delta connection, so no neutral line is present here. And I am assuming that the line impedance is very, very small. And due to this reason, it is possible to write the following thing, that VAB equal to capital VAB, VBC is exactly equal to capital VBC, VCA is exactly equal to VCA. I have written this point from the topological connection, and assumption here is no line impedance. Obviously, I am assuming that source also has no impedance, then only I can able to write like this. So we have already seen this. So let us just verify again, VAB equal to VBC if there is no impedance like this. Similarly, I can generalize it. And once I will know the VAB, VBC, VCA, then obviously it is possible to talk about the phase current. So hence the phase currents are, I can write the phase current, that is IAB, that is equal to VAB by Z delta, and that is exactly same like Z delta. And similarly, I can also able to talk about the other phase current, that is IB BC, that is VBC, Z delta. So these are all things are now obvious. Once we will understood the context, then things become obvious, almost obvious. ICA is VCA by Z delta, and I can also write like this, CA by Z delta. And once I know the IAB, IBC and ICA, and in previous class what we have found that the line current, you can see here, again I am going to the diagram. So IA is the line current here, and if I apply KCL at this particular point, then same like the previous class, I am able to write IA equal to IAB minus ICA. So in that way, it is possible to calculate the line current. So let us again quote that. So what I am going to write here, that the line currents are obtained from the phase currents by applying KCL at nodes A, B and C, and we have already did this in the previous lecture, so there is no need of the extra discussion now. IAB minus ICA, similarly IB is IBC minus IAB, and IC equal to ICA minus IBC. So in this way I am able to talk about the line current. And again, same kind of generalization we have, same like the previous class, that each line currents lags the corresponding phase current by 30 degree, and the magnitude of line current is root 3 times the phase current. So let us, just because in previous class we have already seen that whenever we have delta connected load, so since I am talking on the load side, due to that reason result remains the same. So let us just write in terms of the remark that each line currents lags the corresponding phase current by 30 degree, and the magnitude IL of the line current is root 3 times the magnitude IP of the phase current. So basically IL is root 3 IP. So same like the previous class, and we have seen that how to define IL and IP. So now I'm not going to again discuss that. And alternative way again is that delta delta connected circuit can be converted to Y and Y connected, and after that we can perform that analysis. So I am also not going to discuss that part now. So now let us come to the one question, and after that I will close the today's class. So in this particular problem, I have considered a balanced delta connected load, and I am assuming that impedance of that is given like this, and I am assuming that I have the generator that is delta connected, and again I am assuming the positive sequence means ABC sequence, and VAB that is 330 degree. Now I have to calculate the phase current and the line current. So since I know the load impedance, so again I am going to express it in terms of phasor, and from the analysis we know that VAB is exactly equal to V small a small b. Then I can talk about the phase current, so that is obvious. So just now I have to do the manipulation of this complex number, then I will get this. Similarly, I can calculate the IBC and ICA, and I know that for a delta load the line current always lags the corresponding phase current. So we have seen in this section as well as in previous section by 30 degree, and magnitude is root 3 times the phase current, and here I have already calculated the phase current. So from that one can calculate the line current, and line current now is the phase current and just multiplied by root 3 and 30 degree lags, so minus 30 is here. And similarly I can calculate the other value if I know the IA, then again using positive sequence I am able to calculate IB and IB, IB, IC, and in this way one can solve the problem related to the delta delta connected system, balanced delta delta connected system. So in this section we have discussed the balanced delta delta connection, and we have found the relationship between phase and line current, and finally what we have observed that the line current lags the corresponding phase current by 30 degree, and the magnitude of line current is root 3 times the magnitude of the phase current. So using this discussion I am going to close the today's lecture.